If you want to use feature flags for A/B testing and stress-free releases, then you need to learn about OpenFeature. OpenFeature provides a standard way to implement feature flags into any application, so a standard API and a standard set of rules. This works for many languages and is vendor-agnostic. So if you follow the OpenFeature spec and you want to change provider from, say, LaunchDarkly to GrowthBook, then you don't have to change all of your code. OpenFeature has some key components that help with feature flag evaluation. Let's go through them. So when your application wants to know the value of a feature flag, it communicates with OpenFeature via the evaluation API. Then if there's any extra content that can be added to the feature flag, that can be done via the evaluation context. Then OpenFeature has a concept of hooks. So you can add a hook before the feature flag is sent to the provider or a hook afterwards. And the provider is a tool that can interface with the OpenFeature SDK and the feature flag management system. So this, of course, could be LaunchDarkly, it could be FlagD, it could be anything, as long as there's a provider that can interface with the OpenFeature SDK. So the provider will get the current state of the feature flag based on any evaluation contents or data from the before hook. And then once it gets the state of the feature flag, it sends that information back to the OpenFeature SDK, which can run any after hooks before giving this information to your app, which will enable or disable a feature based on the response it gets. Now, I completely appreciate the fact that if you're seeing this for the first time, it can seem very confusing. But once we go through some code, it will make much more sense. In fact, let's do that now. So this is a very simple React app. And if I click on this button over here, it makes a call to an API and just prints out the message from it. The feature is pretty much done, but I want a bit more control over how it's released. So in the Python API, I'm going to install the OpenFeature SDK and the FlagD provider. And FlagD is an open source feature flag engine. Let's configure OpenFeature with a provider and a client. And then we'll create a variable that uses the OpenFeature client to get a Boolean value with the name of our feature flag and a default value in case FlagD is down. In fact, we'll make that false. Then we'll update this code to show a 404 if the feature flag is not found and return payment successful if it is found. In the React code, we also need the OpenFeature SDK and the FlagD web provider. We'll then set our provider and configure FlagD to listen on localhost port 8013. Then we'll wrap our app with the OpenFeature provider component. We'll import the useFlagReactHook from the OpenFeature React SDK. We'll then create this variable, which uses the useFlagHook and grabs this feature flag name with a default value. Then inside our code, we'll update this card with this ternary, which will show our feature if the flag exists and show this text if it doesn't. To make things easier, I've configured FlagD with Docker Compose. And here is our FlagD flags JSON file, which contains our feature flag with two variants, so on being true and off being false. This flag will be enabled and the default variant will be off. So with FlagD running, we can see the feature doesn't show. But if I update the configuration, without refreshing the page, we can see the feature shows up. And clicking on Buy Now will make the call to the API. This is really cool, but I only want to show the feature to users on desktop and not on mobile. Let's see how we can do that. We can update our React app to pass in some evaluation context, which will be the device type based on the window width. Then in our flags JSON file, we can add a new targeting object, which will check if the device type variable equals mobile, and if it does, we'll change the feature flag to off. If it doesn't, we'll keep it on. Now we can see the feature doesn't show on a mobile width, but if we change it to a desktop width and refresh the page, we can see the feature shows up. Of course, targeting could be done for anything, user ID, browser user agent, or any other value you want to use for A/B testing or a canary release rollout. But now I want to grab some telemetry data from my feature flags. To do that, we can add the OpenTelemetry traces hook, which adds feature flag data to trace spans. We can update our code to include some OpenTelemetry packages and then add this function to export trace data to the OpenTelemetry collector. After that, all we have to do is install the OpenFeature tracing hook, and we can add that to the OpenFeature client like this. If you want to learn more about traces and the OTel collector, then be sure to check out this video. The link should be in the description. Looking at the tracing hook code, we can see that this hook will trigger after the provider gets the flag state from the feature flag management system. But hooks can also run before any flag evaluation takes place. Let's add the OpenTelemetry collector to our Docker Compose file and give it this configuration. Now, whenever we make an API call, we can see some feature flag data in our trace span. If you want a full list of hooks and providers, then be sure to check out the ecosystem tab in the OpenFeature website. I hope you enjoyed this quick overview of OpenFeature. If you want to know more about it, then go ahead and check out their website. And if you enjoyed this content and want to see more, then why not subscribe?